Hey there, how is the lockdown going? I hope everyone is staying home. Many of you want to buy new phones, but because of the lockdown, you're not able to. Wait, that's actually okay. Because there are many cool phones which are around the corner, and we are going to talk about it today. This is Shreyas from Goner, and let's talk about some latest leaks of the upcoming phones. Let's start with the maker of Android, Google. It's early, but we are hearing some leaks and rumors about the new Google Pixel 5. It has a distinct makeover. That one giant triple camera setup at the back was leaked by Front Page Tech. We are expecting the return of the Google Soldier radar chip and the Qualcomm Snapdragon 765G, which is not the top-end processor, but it comes with the integrated 5G modem. An Android 11 developer preview leak suggests that there is a potential reverse wireless charging, as we saw it on the Samsung and Huawei phones. But we don't have the details of it. We need to wait for several months for that. Before the Google Pixel 5, we had the leaks of Google Pixel 4a, which is the younger brother of Pixel 4 and Pixel 4 XL, and the successor of Pixel 3a. The Pixel 3a was one of the most surprising phones of Google, with Google software and Google camera at the reasonable price. We are expecting the same trend in 2020 with the Google Pixel 4a. OnLeaks and 91 Mobiles have produced the same concept renders. The image shows that the phone will opt like the S10 Galaxy punch hole camera cut out at the front. OnLeaks states that the screen size would be around 5.7 to 5.8 inch for the standard model. The back has a smaller square camera model with the fingerprint sensor. There is also leaked hoarding which advertises the price point of $399, which comes to 30,000 rupees if it comes to India. With Samsung S20 line out of the way, we are now hearing rumors for Note 20. Samsung usually releases the Note series at the end of the summer, but the rumors are around the corner already. We get some idea of the possible back of the Samsung Note 20 series. According to the image of the case mold for Note 20, the Note line will follow the new same design of Samsung S20. The only leak we have so far is the Note 20 will have the Snapdragon 865 chipset with the more fine-tuned 120Hz refresh rate display. According to the leaks, the Note series could launch in July along with the rumored Galaxy Fold 2. As we speak of the Samsung Galaxy Fold 2, the leak suggests that it will have the 120Hz display with the S Pen support. The first Samsung Galaxy Fold was an experiment. It has an ability to change a smartphone into a tablet. However, it didn't go well and the 1,50,000 price point didn't help either. The Samsung Galaxy Fold 2 gives Samsung an opportunity to prove that the foldable phones are more than a publicity device. And the new design from the concept creator channel on YouTube brings the rumors and leaks we are hearing. And of course, this is just a concept. But if Samsung is really working on the Galaxy Fold 2 launch alongside the Note 20, the S Pen equipped foldable phone could steal the spotlight from the Note. These were some flagships from Samsung. Now let's talk about a budget device, which is Samsung Galaxy A21s.
Samsung Galaxy A21s, a rumored smartphone from Samsung, has been reportedly spotted on Geekbench. The listing shows some specifications of the phone, which includes Exynos 850 chipset with octa-core processor and the version of Android, which is Android 10. It also states that the Samsung Galaxy A21s will have 3GB RAM on one of the variants. The leaks also suggested that the phone will come with 5000 mAh battery. A report suggests that the Samsung A21s will come with a 2-megapixel micro camera and two storage variants, 32GB and 64GB.
The phone is expected to come in black, blue, red and white color variants. There has been many leaks for the Apple's iPhone 12. And the good news is the leaks looks amazing.
The big news about the camera of the iPhone 12 is that the Apple is including the potential game-changing long-range 3D camera. After multiple leaks, has now launched the new 2020 iPad Pro lineup, and it uses the combination of time of flight and the LiDAR sensor to almost instantly map its environment up to the distance of about 15 feet, which we'll see in the upcoming iPhone 12. Apple is focusing this sensor on augmented reality. If we speak about the design, probably the biggest complaint about the iPhone 12 will be that it looks similar to iPhone X, iPhone XS and iPhone 11 Pro. There's still some hope that the iPhone will reduce the notch, but it's still not moving to the punch-hole display or the under-display camera yet. It will get the new colors though, with navy blue replacing the midnight green for the iPhone 12 Pro and 12 Pro Max. The new LiDAR scanner could make the significant change to the back of the phones. iPhone 12 will come in three variants. The regular iPhone 12, which is for 6.1 inch, the iPhone 12 Pro with 5.4 inch, and the iPhone 12 Pro Max, 6.7 inch. Apple is also expecting to use the next-gen Samsung OLED panels, as well as 120Hz ProMotion refresh rates. The phone will have the Face ID. Also, there are many rumors that the Touch ID will return with an on-display fingerprint. It will come with Apple's A14 chipset, which could deliver performance as close as to MacBook Pro. There is no update about the pricing, however, Apple won't charge you more for 5G models. Apple usually launches the new series in September. However, due to the COVID-19, it may get delayed. You can expect it before Christmas.
Apple is also planning to launch a budget smartphone around June 2020, which would be called as iPhone SE 2020, which comes up to 256GB of storage.
A report obtained by 9to5Mac claims that the official marketing name for the new device is simply being iPhone SE, with the Apple referring to as 2020 version. In addition, a screen protector listed on Apple's online website also confirms the name iPhone SE and hints at the nearing launch. The actual protector is also said to fit iPhone 7 and iPhone 8 models as well, which confirms the device will sport an identical 4.7 inch display. In addition, we learn the new budget iPhone will launch in black, white and red colors. We also get confirmation on the 5 official Apple cases for the device, which includes black and white silicone cases alongside red, black and midnight blue leather options. The report also confirms that the new iPhone will come with A13 Bionic chipset.
The pricing is expected to start at around $399, which comes to 30,000 rupees in India. Before we go further, I would request you to subscribe to my channel and share this video. Hit the like button if it is helpful. OnePlus 8 series is set to launch on April 14th. Company has been teasing a lot about the phones.
In a new report, OnePlus CEO Pete Lau reveals the price estimate of the OnePlus 8 series. Separately, DisplayMate had tested the OnePlus 8 phone's display ahead before its launch. It has been awarded with an A+ grade. The OnePlus 8 Pro seems to have broken 13 display performance records in DisplayMate's testing. Liu told Business Insider that the OnePlus 8 series of phones won't cost more than $1,000, which is roughly around 76,400 rupees. While he didn't detail the exact price of each OnePlus 8 variant, his statement suggests that the most high-end OnePlus variant will be short of $1,000. The OnePlus 8 phones are already confirmed to offer 5G network, and the phones are also teased to be powered with Snapdragon 865 SoC. Both the OnePlus 8 and OnePlus 8 Pro will be available in three colors: Interstellar Grey, Oxy Black and Glacier Green. In addition, ultramarine blue color has been confirmed for the OnePlus 8 Pro, but it's unclear that the option is available for the regular OnePlus 8. Recently, in the new leaks, we can see the leaked screen protectors and the transparent bumper case with the new vanilla color for the OnePlus 8. Here we can see actor Robert Downey Jr., who is the official OnePlus brand ambassador, holding what is believed to be a OnePlus 8 Pro during a recent commercial shoot for the handset. If we speak about the design, it is very similar to the OnePlus 7T. However, it has been moved to the punch-hole camera display instead of the notch, but it looks super thin. OnePlus has announced 120Hz Fluid display for its 2020 handsets. Created in collaboration with Samsung Display, the AMOLED panel will use MEMC tech to automatically smooth out lower frame rate videos of the screen. Plus, it will have a peak brightness of over 1000 nits. The display would be 6.55 inch 1080p panel for the OnePlus 8, with the larger and crispier 6.78-inch Quad HD Plus screen for the OnePlus 8 Pro. Ishan Agrawal's specs release suggests that the OnePlus 8 will ship with triple camera at the back, packing 48MP, 16MP and 2MP cameras. Meanwhile, the OnePlus 8 Pro will reportedly have a quad camera setup, which is dual 48MP cameras and 8MP and 5MP shooters. It may have 16MP selfie cameras on both the models. Recently suggests a 4300mAh battery for the OnePlus 8 and the 4510mAh battery for the OnePlus 8 Pro, alongside the wireless charging. However, no wireless charging on the standard model. The leaks also suggest that the Pro model will finally have the IP68 water resistance for the first time. One of the Pro variants will have 12GB of RAM. As we come close to the launch, a OnePlus 8 Pro was spotted in the wild on a Chinese subway, giving a bloody confirmation to the design. Because of the case, you may not be able to see the color and the details of the device, but it doesn't hide the camera. The number of layout all matches what we have seen in the previous renders.
Compared to OnePlus 8, the OnePlus 8 Pro has a slightly bigger display and an additional camera. Unfortunately, the headphone jacks are not coming to the fore. Keep the headphone dongles around. OnePlus announced Bullet Wireless 2 last May, and now they are planning to announce an affordable version of them. It's called Bullet Wireless Z.
We do not have the launch date yet, but the source claims that the Bullet Wireless Z is likely to go official on 14th April with the OnePlus 8 series. It is expected to come with Bluetooth 5.0, USB-C port and fast charging. The earphones will come in four colors. Three of them matches the OnePlus 8 Pro's variant, which is Glacier Green, Ultramarine Blue and Oxy Black. The fourth version is gold. We haven't seen the gold OnePlus 8 Pro yet. The Bullet Wireless Z look identical with the ongoing Bullet Wireless 2, but they might bring some changes on the inside. It may cost less than the Bullet Wireless 2.
Earlier, we heard that the OnePlus 8 series will be the company's first to have the wireless charging. And now it's official that the company would be releasing the wireless charger on 14th April.
OnePlus says that the Warp Charge 30 wireless will charge the device from 1% to 50% in 30 minutes. Here is the image posted by OnePlus, which says all power, no wires. The image is followed by some leaks render, where we see a vertical dock which allows your phone to charge in a standing position rather than lying flat. The charging dock is set to deliver 30 watts power output, and there is a built-in fan at the rear side to avoid overheating. There is also AI sleep mode, which reportedly turns off the cooling fan at night.
OnePlus has not revealed the price yet, but the rumors suggest that it will cost around 70 euros, which is around 5,800 rupees. OnePlus also states that the wireless charging technology has QI compatibility, which means you will be able to charge your OnePlus 8 with third-party wireless chargers too. OnePlus 8 Lite, which was rumored earlier, will be actually called as OnePlus Z. It would be a mid-range smartphone than an affordable one.
The reports are saying it will use the MediaTek Dimensity SoC instead of the flagship Snapdragon 865. And the news was confirmed by two separate sources. OnePlus Z will sport a 6.4-inch display with the MediaTek Dimensity 1000 processor hidden inside. A report from 91mobile says the device will come with 90Hz refresh rate, punch hole display, and the report also reveals the price, which is tipped around 400 Great Britain pounds, which is approximately 37,500 rupees. The phone may be available in India by July this year. The cameras on the device could see a 48MP primary sensor, 16MP secondary camera, and a 12MP lens sat next to it. The phone will come running a 4000mAh battery with 30W fast charging support, and will be available in two variants, 8GB plus 128GB and 8GB plus 256GB internal storage.
So tell us in the comment section below which phone you are excited about and which one disappoints you. If you like the video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel.